had great pleasure in working with some of the greatest artists. I played with Lord Ehudi Menuhin quite a few times, and we performed together in the United Nations for the 40th year of India's independence. I've collaborated with Stephen Grappelli, the greatest jazz violinist of that time. And we did albums called Conversations, and we did a major tour in India. And in fact, when I started my, this year being my father's centenary, birth centenary year, when we started Lakshminarayana Global Music Festival in 1992, both Menuhin and Grappelli were the honorary patrons, both the violinists. And both of them have come to India also and performed, and we have done a lot of collaborative work. And also in here, like some of the greatest jazz artists like Herbie Hancock, George Duke, Stanley Clarke, Al Jarreau, and Corky Siegel, many, many great artists, Larry Coryell, they've all, I've had the opportunity to collaborate and write compositions and record with them over a period of time. And recently when Mr. Paxton, VET Jazz, wanted them to perform in my festival for their television show, all these, some of the great artists from here collaborated, performed in Delhi. It was shot there and they showed it here in VET Jazz. So a lot of collaborative work have happened. And the latest one, what I have done is, we had the violinists from different parts of the world paying tribute to my father. We did a six-city tour in India where we had a violinist from Algeria. They play the violin upside down. And the country fiddle, Mark O'Connor from here, New York. And then we had the brilliant Norwegian folk fiddler playing Hardinger fiddle. So like that, we have different styles of violins we presented. I've had always had great happiness doing these things because my interest was when I came here to do my master's in Western classical music. My focus was composition and Western music. So using that knowledge, I've had an opportunity to write for New York Philharmonic. When Maestro Mehta asked me to write a composition for India Festival in 85, we did four nights concerts, Fantasy on Vedic Chant. Subsequently, when both the presidents, Indian and USSR president, were there in Moscow, we did a big, big, big show with the Moscow Symphony, Chinese Beijing Symphony. So we have collaborative work has happened in different ways, either as a chamber context with jazz artists, or classical artists like Menuhin or Ruggiero Ricci, people like that. Then in a major way with the symphony orchestras like New York Philharmonic, London Philharmonic, and the Swiss Romand and major orchestras. Whenever you do any collaboration, for the success of the collaboration is very, very important. You study the other system also. Because otherwise if two people, however great they are, they just play together, it'll be like a jam session. Yes, they just get together, play. They finalize the ending and beginning. But when you really want to do a collaborative work, if you study their music, whatever way you have to, then write composition, knowing their forte and try to push their boundaries and push your boundary and create a new direction, that becomes much more intellectually challenging and rewarding. So it is very important. Otherwise, it's very easy for two people to get together. You improvise, I improvise, we finish together. Initially, the, you know, violin is probably the most played instrument in the world and most popular instrument. If you see any city in Europe or US, every city has an orchestra, sometimes more than one orchestra, two orchestras sometimes, many more than that. So in an orchestra, majority of the instruments are violinists. So violin being a Western instrument, technically there are compositions, very advanced composition, which have been written by some of the European composers in the past, like Paganini, Sarasvati, Asse, and different people have written technically very complex things. So they have pushed their boundary really because of the, some of the composers who were violinists themselves. But in the Indian music, the whole contrast started as an accompanying instrument. But in the West, whenever anybody learns a violin, their dream is to become a soloist. So where they play alone or play as a soloist with an orchestra, so you become the, you know, main focus of the concert. But if that doesn't work out, sometimes they form a chamber group, like a string quartet, quintet, or trio or things. Then subsequently, otherwise they have some chamber orchestras, they become a part of the orchestra or part of a major orchestra, symphony orchestra, philharmonic orchestra, and slowly try to push up to getting to the concertmaster level. But in Indian music, when it was introduced, one of the earliest exponent was Balaswami Dikshita, Muthuswami Dikshita's disciple. And they introduced that generally, they introduced the violin as an accompanying instrument for the main artist, for vocal or any other instrument. And it slowly became the most important accompanying instrument because it was a fretless and bowed instrument. Also, if you see, there is no concert literally in South India without a violin now, because violin is the most important accompanying instrument. But my father was responsible for shifting the paradigm of whole thought. He wanted to make the violin as a solo instrument. 1935 or so, when he started playing, he said, we should make this violin also as a primary solo instrument so that it could be on par with Western instruments, like any other Western instrument, particularly Western violin. So we should be able to play in a mainstream audiences in the West. So in order to achieve that, we had to develop a lot of new technique, because our technique was accompanying technique, not a solo technique. There were no repertoire written for the violin to improve the technique. So he pushed the boundaries, expanded the range, introduced using a lot of the little finger techniques, which was not there at all at the time, a lot of bowing techniques. And subsequently, in his path, he formed a violin trio with three of his sons, and subsequently, I developed a lot of techniques using some of the Veena technique, which is one of the most important traditional Indian instrument for us. So the violin took a position of solo position, and we became just soloists, left alone, leaving alone accompaniment. But that period, it was very difficult. Everybody had to accompany. Once in a blue moon, they played solo. They were not able to say, okay, I'm going to play only solo, I'm not going to accompany, because that violin was not developed to that extent at that time. But it has changed now. Now we are so happy to see, you know, a lot of the future generation, next generation, after my generation, a lot of people have been courageous enough to follow us and start playing violin solos. A lot of people are using modified violin, like we started five-string instrument, we started multiple variation of a regular violin, sympathetic strings like that. Everybody is using a contact microphone. The whole generation has shifted from thinking of, oh, I want to be an accompanist, play with the famous artists like Chembai Vaidyanatha Bhagavatar or people like that. At that generation, I want to be a soloist. That shift, my father was responsible. In fact, in that connection, we are having a big celebration of my father's birth centenary. He was born in India is a brilliant visionary, so he created a lot of technique. So Lakshminarayana Global Music Festival, we are doing all over the world. And I've been very fortunate, a lot of the great violinists from all over the world, they're all coming to pay tribute to him play in India. There was a time where, you know, at one period, we had almost like 10, 12 solid great artists dominating the scene. There was Chembai Vaidyanatha Bhagavatar, Chamungudi Srinivasayyar, Maharajaburam. Then we had M. S. Subbalakshmi, D.K. Patamal, Madhuramani Iyer, G.N. Balasubramaniam. The instrumental side, like T.R. Mahalingam, probably the greatest flutist of all time. Paul Katmani Iyer, greatest mridangam player of all time. All this period was there simultaneously. It was a golden time. Since then, you know, there are other artists who have started, who are doing a lot of great things and tried to push the thing. But I'm really hoping soon we'll get to a place where we have those kind of stalwarts, many, many of them at the same period. So when it happens, what happens is everybody tried to push the boundary more and more. Instead of two, three people singing. As if you go to Alathu Brothers concert, you know, you have something special, which is their trademark. Go to Chamagudi's concert, it is something special, GNB something special. Is at the same time we had like so many great artists, same thing instrumentalists too. But I think I'm really looking forward to that kind of I think where, you know, music will become such a powerful source at that time. But now what has happened, because of the lot of the television programs which is happening, everybody tried to go to, it's a fast track to become a celebrity. If you go to a, you know, one of those shows, become one of the, even one or two in the ranking, immediately you get a tour, you perform, your life is immediately, everybody knows you because of the television, media and publicity. Then after 2-3 years, you know, the next guy comes or next girl comes, so this life is gone. It's so some over there, whereas in those days, you know, one became popular because of many, many years of hard work, many, many years of putting passionately all your energy and hard work in one direction to master the instrument or vocal, whatever you are doing. So you really wanted to become a true master. So then people started listening to you by slowly, by word of mouth. People started saying, oh, this is fantastic, that person is great. So over a period of time, they built up a reputation. There was a track record. There was hard work for many years. Now, instantly, you know, sometime you get known. Some people are very, very talented and some people are lesser talented. But with the media and all those things, sometime that balance is not there.